This is an intro to solving radical equations. All right. So if you square something, you get two of them, right? You get 9. So remember with the radicals, if you square a 4, you now have that perfect pair to take one out. So what's basically happening is the square and the square root are canceling each other to give you 9 and 3. Why not negative 3? Well, because if you write that one twice, you get a negative times a negative, which is positive. Squares also cancel your negatives. Okay, so here's what we can remember. They cancel and give you 7, cancels and gives you x. So the square cancels the square root. All right, what happens to the negative? The square also cancels the negative. So a square cancels the negative, because a negative times a negative is a positive. All right, so when we're dealing with equations, now that we know a square will cancel a square root, we're trying to solve this equation and this one, which means we need to get that x outside the radical. So what do we need to do to both sides of the equation to remove the radical? Square it. If we square both sides, it will remove the radical. We get x equals 25. All right, you still need to check it, so come back down here, and that's a check. All right, let's try another. So we square it, cancels the radical, and leaves us with 2x, and then there's our equation. So if we divide by 2, x equals, I like decimals, so 4.5. We still need to check it, so we plug it back in. That's the square root of 9. And yes, checks perfectly. So there's our answer, and there's our answer. Now I have confidence in you, so let me have you try this one. Hit pause and give it a shot. And there you go. You should have 4. How do we know it's right? We don't. So let's check it. So that's 8 plus 1, which is 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. So there it is. And that's an intro to solving radical equations. So the main idea is to get rid of a radical, you square both sides.